Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my channel. If you want to see the upcoming tutorials, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the 19th episode about SharePoint Modern Site. In this episode, we'll create SPFX webpart and get some API data. Before creating a webpart, we need to make sure we have necessary tools added on our machine. So in new tab, search SPFX human generator. Open the first link. Click getting started. Set up development environment. The first thing we need is Node.js. If this is not installed on your machine, feel free to click this link. You can download and install Node.js on your machine. Then we need a code editor. I'm using Visual Studio Code. Then we need Gulp, Yeoman, and SharePoint Generator. If these are not installed on your machine, feel free to copy and run these command lines. We are creating web parts, so click web parts, getting started, build and deploy your first web part. Copy this command line and open your text editor. Make sure you have created a project folder. I have created a folder called person info. Then open the terminal, so click view. Terminal. Make sure you select PowerShell over here. You can paste your command line and hit enter to run them. Add a solution name. Person info is fine, so just hit enter key. Choose web part and add a web part name. I will add person info. Then finally, choose React as a framework. This might take some time depending on your machine, so let's just wait for the time being. We also need to install Axios so that we can work on the API. So here you can type npm install Axios and hit enter to run. To run the project, type gulp serve. Let's wait until it shows reload. Now scroll slightly to the top, copy this query string and go back to the home site. You can refresh the home site and at the end of the URL, you can paste the query string and hit enter key. Now we are in debug mode, means whatever change we make on the code, it should appear over here. Now, let's add person info web part. So edit the site, click plus icon, search person info. So this is the web part that we will be modifying. For now, let's just click republish. Now let's make some small changes on the web part. So open the text editor, open src folder, web parts, components, and open personinfo.dsx file. For style, you can open personinfo.module.scss. For style, I will simply copy from my project, then open personinfo.dsx file. Here, let's remove these unwanted divs. Let's update the class name. I just want to add a class called person info. Remove all this const and remove the escape import. Now inside this section, let's simply add a text webpart. Let's check the preview after it shows reload over here. Refresh the site, and now it just shows webpart over here. Great. Now let's make the actual change. We'll work on JSON placeholder API. Scroll down and click on users. We will use this data to show on our person info webpart. So open the text editor, and the first thing we need to do is we need to import Axios from Axios. Then we need a state, and I will add empty persons array. Then we need component date mount lifecycle hook. Add axios.get. We need the URL of the API. Add them over here. Then we'll add the response in persons variable. Finally, let's update the state using this.setState, and we'll pass persons as an object. If we look at the data, we got array and some objects. So we will be using a map function. So inside this section, let's add a map function. So add this.state that persons dot map. We can now access person. Add div and s2 tag. In this s2 tag, I want to show name. So in the curly brace, you can add person dot name. Let's also add a class name in this div tag, styles.holder. When working on SCSS, instead of quotes, we have to use curly braces. Check the site now, and you should see names over here. Now let's also add email address and a city name. So I will add them in ULLI. In first li, I want to show email, so add person dot email. Then I want to show city, so add person dot city is under address, so we have to add address dot city. Let's check the site again. And this time we can see name, email, and city. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll add titles to this web part and deploy them. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you and see you soon.